Stay tuned. The buzz starts now.
From the NW TV studio on the campus of Northwestern Oklahoma State University, this is The Buzz.
Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to The Buzz. The fall semester is in full swing here at Northwestern, and we have a lot that has been happening. Let's get started on what's going on around campus.
Another annual donor dinner has been put in the books, but it was the first for a celebrity's mother. Kevin Durant's mother, Wanda Pratt, spoke at the donor dinner on September 25th. 187 people actually attended the event, and they chose her because she's such a good motivational speaker. And I looked on her website, she has her own website, and I looked on it, and it said, her passion is to guide her audience to realize that hope is alive inside, encourage them to dream, and help them truly believe they can achieve the future they want.
That's very inspirational.
Really, yes.
And that's a good mom.
Yeah, I thought it was a big deal that she actually came to, like, our small little campus and that they got her to come and talk. And she actually did a question and answer. So, like, she let them ask her questions, like, about Kevin, whatever they wanted to ask, and then she, like, interacted with them that way. I thought that was really cool.
That's really cool.
Yeah.
I wonder if she told any, like, embarrassing stories about him. Come on.
Yeah. So, definitely, it was definitely pretty cool.
Fall is just around the corner, and what better way to kick it off than with my favorite fall event, Homecoming. Homecoming is October 18th this year. The parade starts at 10 a.m. that day. It's at the downtown square. The football game for the boys of fall starts at 3 p.m. against East Central. Do you guys know about Homecoming buttons?
Mm-hmm. I have heard.
Yes, I've heard, like, the theme that they're doing.
Oh, the theme this year is
The Hunger Games?
Catching Fire, right?
Catching Fire.
Yeah. Okay, yes.
And then Homecoming buttons are for sale for $10 all over the campus, but for the signs, the discounts are at tons of local businesses if you buy one through the 13th through the 18th. You could also win a $500 check for on the number on the and everything can be used between the 16th and the 18th for the rest of that. Also, the candidates this year for freshman Rangers student and team have already started campaigning. The first round of voting will be Monday the 6th and Tuesday the 7th for freshman queen and the top three candidates for Ranger queen and also for Ranger queen. And it will be the final for Ranger Team and Queen will be unveiled at the football game.
And it's going to be voting is held in the Student Center?
Right.
Cool. So everybody can go and vote in the Student Center.
Yes. For Ranger Team is Abby Tillman, Sydney Lowe, Morgan Renbacher, and Lauren Davis from the UNI campus. And just a little side note, I'm also running for Ranger Team. And I've been working really hard putting together a lot of good things. And I wanted to wish everybody a good luck.
Yes, definitely. That's exciting. It'll be fun.
Yeah, it's like a lot of fun.
Yes.
So, October is approaching, and Halloween is almost here, and Northwestern's Drama Club, the cast of players, is hosting their annual game of Human vs. Zombie this week, the week of Halloween, sorry. This exciting game is a campus-wide, and everyone can play. The game begins with multiple humans and a few zombies, and if you're tagged by a zombie, well, if you've ever seen The Walking Dead, I think you know what happens.
Yes.
You become a zombie. But do you want to know how to survive the apocalypse?
Yes.
Just throw some socks, and it just stuns. And it stuns the zombies in their tracks. Have you guys ever played Human? It's a lot of fun.
The whole
campus gets involved, and there's some people who are zombies, and some people who are humans. And you're running around. You're wearing bandanas. You're carrying around socks. It's like a whole crazy
thing. Can anybody be a zombie, or just the drama club is being zombies?
No. They start off with a few zombies, and if you're caught, then you become a zombie. And then you walk around like a zombie.
On your face?
Yeah, you you can. There's a bowl
for
people
behind like that.
Yeah.
It's like
awesome.
Full for
somebody to just throw a balloon.
Yeah.
That sounds like really good events they're putting together. That's exciting. Yeah.
So guys should totally check it out. I love it. Yes. So if you ever feel you're up to the challenge, go out and play, and may the Sox forever be in your favor.
Since we are on topic of campus-wide fun, why not use this opportunity to introduce the Northwestern community to a new student organization called Something Greater. NWTV7 reporter Veronica Nelson has more.
Thanks, Liza. This week I got an inside look at a new campus club called Something Greater. Something Greater is a faith-based club where students come together to worship and watch a live church video sermon. Something Greater is in the Ranger Perk located off the cafeteria. They meet every Tuesday at 7 p.m.
Up next, Travis Mangiano will give us an update on Ranger sports. Keep it here on the Buzz.
Welcome to NWTV7 Sports. We're so happy you could join us today. I'm Travis Herman-Smith alongside my favorite, Adriana Becerra. It was another amazing weekend in Northwestern sports, beginning with women's soccer, as the Lady Rangers hosted two home matchups against the Lady Tigers of East Central University and Southern Nazarene last weekend. Lee Diane Capo-Bianco scored her fifth goal of the season, coming from a nice streak pass off Northwestern forward Ellen Trotter in the first half to give the Lady Rangers a 1-0 lead. However, with ECU's intense defensive play throughout the contest, the Lady Tigers forced Northwestern to commit two overtime situations, which resulted in ECU scoring one last goal at the end of the second overtime to tie the game 1-1. This marks the Lady Rangers' first tie of the season against a Great American Conference opponent. Later on in game two of the homestand against Southern Nazarene, the Lady Rangers came up short yet again, 2-0. It was Lee Diane Capo-Bianco who was prepared for the Lady Rangers, providing a major spark on defense, but Southern Nazarene's offense eliminated the Lady Rangers' chances as they scored two goals late in the match to secure the win. The Lady Rangers are 4-2 on the year and 1-1 in Great American Conference play, with their next matchup on the road in Arkansas against Wachita Baptist at 1 p.m. Now we are going to turn over to Adriana with a look into Division I football standings.
Thanks, Travis. There's not much movement in the NCAA Division I college football standings. The top nine ranked teams are still all undefeated. Topping the list at number one is Florida State, who are the reigning national champions. This week, a few teams within the top 25 standings will have big tests coming their way. Three big matchups come from teams in the SEC. Number six, Texas A&M, will face number 12, Mississippi State, on the road. Ole Miss, ranked 11th, will take on number 3 ranked Alabama at home, and number 5 ranked Auburn will face number 15 LSU at home. These games could cause movement within the standings, especially within the top 10 spots. It'll be fun to see where the teams move after this weekend. In upcoming sports here at Northwestern, Ranger football will travel to Arkansas for a 3 p.m. kickoff Saturday to face Division II powerhouse Henderson State University, who's ranked number 7 in the country according to the latest NCAA Division II polls. And Travis, this should be quite a test for the Rangers coming off such a devastating loss last week at Southern Arkansas.
Adriana, you are a sports genius, you know, and for that reason.
And pretty too.
It will be a tough call for that matchup yet indeed. Also, more Ranger sports coming up this week as women's volleyball will have two matches at home Friday and Saturday against Midwestern State and Southern Arkansas. Well, that'll wrap things up for us today on NWTV7 Sports. I am Travis Herman-Smith, alongside my favorite, Adriana Becerra. Catch us for more sports news at www.rangerpulse.com. Stay tuned. There's more 7 News to come after the break.
Growing up against young teenage girls, the Amanda Show was a real hit. Amanda Bynes is quite the comedian. Unfortunately, today, she isn't quite the perfect role model for the younger generation. Amanda was arrested Sunday morning and charged with her second DUI. The report stated that she was pulled over after stopping in the middle of a Los Angeles intersection. She then was given a field sobriety test, which she could not complete. She was booked into jail and given a $15,000 bond and was released later that day. How could a child star go down such a bad road? What do you guys think? I mean, I remember watching her as a young teenage girl and just thinking that she was hilarious and beautiful and
funny.
I know.
Like, she was one of the only girls that, like, had her stuff together.
show we thought.
So
so many things about her show, like if it ever happens in any other show, because I've seen kind of like little spoofs of her show, like, I don't know, the things in Lost Boys and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Remember those?
Yes. It was very
very age-appropriate show. Mm-hmm. You know, she's actually been in and out of rehab, her second DUI. People say that they've seen her at her all-time low. So it doesn't look like she's going to be doing much better. I hope that she is, but I'll say that she isn't. So. I hope that this generation of child stars will continue to be a positive influence on our youth today.
The Barton Bellows are back in Pitch Perfect 2, the follow-up of the summer 2012 musical comedy. It's going to follow Fat Amy and Becca through their senior year at Barton University and will be released on May 15th. And I can't wait to see it. I mean, I thought the first one was hilarious.
Oh,
yes.
I know I didn't have songs.
Fat Amy is by far one of my favorite. I mean, she's
And I've heard, like, whenever she acts, she does most of hers, like, ad-libs. Like, she, like, comes up with it on her own.
Yeah. Well, she's her own person.
Yeah.
I mean, her
she's
role
really
is to be her
song.
Yes.
I
think so.
I
yeah.
just love
yeah.
that.
Yeah. And I love Anna Kendrick, too, because I never really expected her to be able to sing, because I saw her in all these other movies.
Yes.
And then she could sing, and I was like, oh, my gosh. Like, she's amazing.
Yeah.
She got nominated for Oscar and everything.
Yeah. Definitely a favorite.
Yes. It'll definitely be one that check out, definitely.
Yeah.
So.
You can bend your arm, your leg, your friend's leg, and you can also bend the truth. So is it true that the iPhone 6 Plus isn't as durable as they say? Well, I found out just how bendable it really was. The experts have weighed in on the debate, saying the iPhone 6 is not so bendy after all. The Watchdog magazine did a flex test and showed that it didn't start deforming until after 90 pounds.
Wow.
Didn't start like actually breaking apart until 110 pounds was applied to it. So it is false. It does not bend in your pocket unless you're over.
Yeah.
Maybe if you sat on a leg.
Yeah.
Unless you're
like,
boom.
And sat on your phone, which is like any iPhone.
Yeah, I agree.
So.
Yeah. I think there's been a lot of like, you know, haters on the iPhone 6, you know.
I feel like it's the Galaxy users. I feel like they're just haters. I feel like they're
Stop hating on Apple, guys.
Well, even their commercials are comparing themselves to the iPhone.
Yeah.
On the, I mean, literally on their commercial, they say that commercial about Siri.
Yeah, like how she can't
Siri
do that.
Doesn't know my name.
Yes.
Nice to know that it is.
Gotta black out the haters, Apple.
Yeah.
So in box office news, Denzel Washington's new movie, The Equalizer, triumphed last weekend. The film made up to $35 million, which is $10 million more than expected. Critics were extremely impressed, and Denzel's second collaboration with director Antoine Fuqua, who he worked with in a film, Training Day, that was really well received. So have you guys heard the buzz on Denzel Washington or no?
I've heard briefly, but anything with Denzel is kind of a big deal.
Yeah. It's really a big deal. You gotta love Denzel Washington.
Yeah, I mean, you're a fan,
yeah,
right?
I'm a big fan of him. Ever since Philadelphia, I can't get over it. Yeah. He's got this, dad way about him that's like, you're gonna do what I say, it doesn't matter.
And then I'm like, I know what I'm doing, I know I'm gorgeous,
and
I know
that's
that I'm right.
But yes, this film is about a man named McCall, who decided to put his vicious past behind him, but is forced to awaken it again when he meets a girl named Carrie, who is played by Chloe Grace Moretz, who is under the control of Russian gangsters. It's a real haunting tale about a man who uses his dark past to save someone else's future. It's really good, so make sure you check it out.
I will, definitely. I can't wait. Welcome back. Today during Lifestyle segment, we are going to give you tips on how to avoid that dreaded freshman 15 pounds. The first thing is don't skip. Don't skip anything. Experts say that skipping meals to try and lose weight is actually makes it worse because your body goes into like a hibernation period where it doesn't burn the calories that you intake as fast. So in other words, like it slows down your metabolism.
them, and then it makes it worse.
Yeah.
I think experts say you're supposed to consume 6 small meals a day. That doesn't mean 6 full meals of, you know, big, large dinner portions.
Yeah.
You just have your Burger King,
McDonald's,
yeah.
things like that. I don't think that's what they're talking about.
No.
That's what they mean.
Also, save your quarters for the laundry. Skip the vending machines. There is no nutritional value in most of the things in the sold in vending machines. And it would be a lot cheaper if you would just go buy your own healthy snacks, like trail mix or like a bag of popcorn.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone knows I keep a ton of snacks at all times in my bag.
Yes.
So almonds are also really good.
Yeah, I love almonds. Oh,
yeah.
Man.
Any fruit.
Yes,
yeah.
Go-to fruit.
Good
yeah.
fruit. You can never go wrong with fruit. That's what
like
I'm saying.
Like, chocolate and strawberries, they
yes.
can go bad throughout the day. Like, if you eat them that day, like, you'll be fine.
Mm-hmm.
They'll be delicious.
Nature's candy, guys.
Yeah. Also, drink water. Students should try to be drinking up to 8 ounces of water a day before any meal. One study in particular found those individuals who did so saw a 44% boost in weight loss.
Wow.
I'm not to talk about drinking water. Personally, I'm not a huge fan of drinking plain water. But there are lots of things such as Crystal Light. I know Dasani has come out with a little plastic bottle that you can
yes.
use.
Yeah.
I love
Fuji.
So there's
really
no excuse for not drinking water.
Right.
I personally don't drink pop. I don't drink anything carbonated. And I don't drink alcohol because it makes you bloated.
Well, I do love Dr. Pepper. That's my weakness. Every once in a while, it's okay. So you can cheat sometimes.
That's all we have for today. Thank you so much for joining us. We have a good day. We'll see you next time.